Hello and welcome to a quick preview on Farming Simulator 19 pre-Gamescom edition. Gamescom is happening again this year in Cologne, Germany, between 21st and 25th August. If you are visiting, you will be able to play a preview version of FS19 in Hall 8.1, where Giants has its booth. For everyone else, I guess we will get to see promotional material and some of the first in-game video footage. Many YouTubers will be there as well, so I'm sure we will get a glimpse of the preview version running in some form or another. Alright, here is a list of all the features put together from Giants Forum, Dev Blogs, Discord and other promotional channels, so enjoy! Farming Simulator 19 will be released on November 20th, 2018 for PC, Mac, Xbox One and PS4. Pre-orders have already started and you can get two versions. The Day 1 edition is available on all platforms and includes a bonus vehicle, a Mahindra Retriever, that's a small 4x4 UTV. There is also a Collector's Edition available for PC, including another exclusive vehicle, a John Deere XUV 865M. Alright, so PC gamers want to know what they need to run this, right? Here is the official spec sheet from Giants. Two things to note, Farming Simulator is not multi-threaded very well, so a CPU with high single-threaded clock speeds is to be preferred. Meaning, if your choice is between many cores at low clock speeds, or at least 4 cores at high clock speeds, go with the high clock speeds one. The GPUs mentioned here are for the lowest settings. If you want to aim at very high settings, you should go for at least a GTX 1060 or AMD 580 with 6-8GB VRAM, which has been mentioned in Giant's Discord channel. The first big change you will notice in Farming Simulator 19 is right at the start of the game, when you will be asked to choose your game mode. Yes, that's right, there are no old difficulty settings anymore, prices and costs will be tied to your game mode. You can start as New Farmer, which includes a farm, some implements and some money in the bank. This is basically what you used to from previous versions. You can also compare this to a medium difficulty setting. You can also start as a farm manager, meaning you get nothing but a big bank account. So you will decide for yourself what land to buy, what to build there, which machines to purchase. You could consider this easy mode. The third option is start from scratch. That is the hardcore option, meaning you get basically nothing, not even much money. You will probably have to work your way up doing work for other farmers first, or take up a large bank loan. We expect Giants to talk more about these game modes during Gamescom. We want to know more about in-game yields, machine costs and systems like wear and tear that will also influence overall game difficulty. Another thing you encounter right at the beginning of the game are the new maps, but we know very little of them at the moment. We have confirmation of 3 maps, one of them being the Estancia Lapajo from FS17 Platinum Edition, a South American map featuring sugarcane. The second map will be a US-American map called Ravenport, probably featuring large fields for big machines. The third map has been confirmed as being West European, called Felsbrunn, featuring the Alpine outskirts of South Germany. A short work in progress video of the map has been released as well. We fully expect Giants to give us much more information about all the maps, their intended focus and maybe even some more footage of them. They will use the Felsbrunn map for Gamescom, so you can at least see that one. The largest feature in Farming Simulator 19 will be the farm creation system. This includes multiple features, one being that all of the map consists of plots of land now. Those plots include fields, forests and open land. They can be purchased and sold again, and while you own them, you can create fields, place objects, create your own farm, or plant or cut trees. Creating your own farm or changing a farm to your liking is the second major part of this feature. All buildings are now placeable, including animal sheds and pastures. Now, when you place a building, the terrain will change the contours of the land, meaning the geometry will adapt. But not only that, you will also be able to change the textures to fit the newly created landscape. Many pre-created objects will be available to you at launch to customize your farm. They will be upgradable and give you a sense of progression. The system is open for modding, so expect many good things to happen here. This feature also has some implications for multiplayer. You will be able to own land in multiplayer too, and the other players won't be able to harvest your fields without permission. As this is one of the main features for Farming Simulator 19, we fully expect to see more of it at Gamescom. I guess they let us place and upgrade a farm in the demo, or at least show us how it works in detail. The mission system in FS19 will get a large overhaul. You won't have to drive to a field to look for missions anymore. There is now a whole section in the new interface dedicated to missions alone. The list will include your destination, reward, and implement requirements. You will also be able to choose to bring your own equipment or lease some from the farmer. There will be no pressure to do the mission as the timers are gone. Also, if you decide to have something better to do, you can abort a mission. The range of the missions has been extended as well. They will include fieldwork, harvest, transport, baling, and weed control. While a mission is active, everything else on the map will progress as normal, meaning plants on other fields will continue to grow. In multiplayer, you can do all these missions as a group. In single player, you can use the helper to do simple tasks as usual. We hope that we will get to see the new interface at Gamescom, including a more detailed view on the mission section. The biggest revelation for Farming Simulator 19 was, of course, the addition of John Deere as a brand. For now, we know that John Deere will feature multiple vehicles, like the 8400R, and a UTV will be included as premium giveaway in the collector's edition of the game. Another addition will be the Echo Ideal Harvester, branded Fendt and Massey Ferguson. We also know of the Wilson brand, with their Pace Setter semi-trailers. Elmer's Manufacturing announced 3 of their grain carts to be included in the game as well. We have also seen the Fendt 1100 MT track version in one of the screenshots already, and the brand has been confirmed by Giants. There is also a Case IH cotton harvester available, as cotton is a new crop in FS19. Bednar, a manufacturer offering many different tools, and Samson, mainly known for their manure and slurry implements, have also been confirmed. Community manager Lizardarn told us that nearly all brands from the previous game will stay in the game, but not all DLCs will carry over. During Gamescom, we hope to see some more new equipment in action, maybe even some new crops and machines to harvest them. Multiplayer is and has been a popular addition to the Farming Simulator games, and Giants even started the Farming Simulator Championship, a baling and bale stacking competition. Farming Simulator 19 will continue to provide a cooperative multiplayer experience up to 16 players. The new mission system will allow players to work together on tasks and split the rewards. All players have their own bank account now and can transfer funds to each other. The new system of owning land in FS19 will also translate to multiplayer, meaning players will own their own land. Nobody will be able to work on land they don't own, but they can be granted permission to do so by other players. This rights management system is also true for vehicles. All these systems allow for a new multiplayer mode called competitive mode. This mode will support at least 4 players and stack them against each other. Further details are not known yet, but Giants is internally testing up to 8 players for this mode. Our guess is that goals can be set, with players competing to reach them first. We fully expect Giants to put emphasis on this during Gamescom, telling us more about how players can compete with each other. Who knows, maybe they will even have a small bale stacking competition going on as well. Giants once again decided to improve on their engine to adapt to the ever-growing demand for realistic graphics. They announced multiple features that will improve the visual part of the game. Screen space ambient occlusion will improve on shadows. Global illumination, light scattering and HDR rendering allow for more realistic lighting. The sky will be dynamic and the sun will act as a light source. Clouds will be voxel-based and be able to influence lighting as they build up to storms. Volumetric fog will scatter the light. Bloom, adaptive eyesight and depth of field will simulate human vision. But that's not all, other minor improvements will change the appearance of the game as well. The first change everyone will notice will be the new transparent UI. It will have a list of icons that will bring you directly to a subsection, and it will also no longer require you to restart the game after some changes in the setting. Giants finally decided that enough is enough, rain should not go through buildings and objects any longer. With rain being stopped by objects, windshield wipers will make it into the game as well, with all vehicles featuring them. When creating your character at the start of the game, you will get some more customization options, like choosing your gender, hair, skin color, caps, vests, shirts, sunglasses, and decals of known brands. When you buy your tractors and equipment, a completely new shop interface will greet you. It will be fully 3D, showing the object of choice and its stats, even adapting to configuration changes in real time. Also, the interior of vehicles will get an improvement as well, adding a light source, backlit dashboards, and moving pedals. Vehicles will now show hoses going to the attached machines, but they will be non-functional. Also, vehicles will now show wear and tear as they need more maintenance. When driving over fields, plants will now be pushed out of the way and even destroyed, depending on what wheels are on the vehicle. To increase immersion, we will see wildlife like deer and birds around the map. They will be purely cosmetic, of course. Gamescom should give us a first impression of how the game and its new effects change the mood of the scenery and visual style. We don't expect to see all features yet, but I'm sure Giants did work hard on the demo to show what they want to achieve. We guess you are as excited as we are to see the game in motion. Farming Simulator 19 will not only add some big changes, but many little things will extend and improve the gameplay experience. We will get two new crop varieties to play with, oats and cotton. Oats will pretty much work like existing crops and be fed mainly to horses, while cotton will get completely new harvesters to pick it off the fields. Weeds will be introduced for the first time and will grow by themselves. You will have tools at your disposal to get rid of them, of course. Weeders will no longer fertilize the ground, but instead they will remove weeds during their early growth stage. Later on, you can use sprayers to put them down without killing your plants in the process. A whole new wear and tear system is coming to the game, meaning your machines will degrade over time and need repairs. The degradation will also show on the vehicles, and they will lose performance if you don't repair them. Another gameplay addition will be a simplified soil compaction system that will influence how often you have to plow a field. Different crops will have a different effect on soil compaction. To counter that, you can, of course, plow your field, or, with another new addition to the game, spread lime on your fields to delay compaction. The lime will need spreading and will also be visible on the ground. With the new farm creation system in place, players will now be able to freely set up their farm, including stables, sheds, and pastures. Different sizes will determine how many animals you can own, with a large version offering unlimited capacity. Talking about animals, we will get to tend to chickens, cows, pigs, sheep, and for the first time, horses and a companion dog. Now, horses are the big new addition. You will be able to hold 16 at a time. There will be 8 different types to grant diversity, and you can name each one of them. You will need to feed and train them by riding and grooming them, and all that work will make them level up to 5 stars, which will grant you the highest price when selling them. The dog, on the other hand, will just be there to follow you around, no major gameplay involved. Coming back to smaller features, vehicles will now destroy crops when driving over them. How much depends on the wheels they use. Crops will also bend out of the way at certain stages, so no more sticking through objects. Minor improvements include physics, vehicle physics, and the helper. Milk will require transport to the vendor. You can sleep through the nights now. And ground textures can be replaced as part of the farm creation system. We fully expect to see the dog and maybe even horses during Gamescom. Also, the new crops and weeds should be in the demo as well, and maybe we will get to see lime spreading too. With that said, we have reached the end of our Gamescom preview. You can find the link to the full feature list in the video description below. Now, we did leave out modding as a feature because it's kind of a specialized topic, but we will include that in our Gamescom review after the show.